There's something I need to tell you.
You tried to murder my dad.
Come here, Serena.
My dad gave that to me to wear at my very first game. You can wear it to yours.
6 months?
I was going to tell you sooner.
I will help you and love you. Will you marry me?
I can't marry you again.
The goods are ordered. Daddy's on his way.
Caitlin has made her feelings clear. I don't want her having anything to do with this. She can't find out about next week.
Angus! You might want to add cereal to that list.
Right.
Oh. And milk.
This is too much, I can't do this.
Whoa, I'll do it. It's no bother.
Fine, Bob. You do that. You sort all this.
Jeez, oh, how much food do we need?
This isn't food. I haven't even started with food yet. This is Christmas presents, birthday presents for Kenzie, things for the baby.
But we're still on double sleep figures until Christmas, and the wee man's birthday. And the baby, you've got...
2.5 months?
Exactly, ages.
To do all this? It's never ending.
But it's halved.
What?
The shopping, the presents, the stuff you need to sort for the baby, it's all halved. I said I would support you, and I will, starting the new.
Now?
Well, no, right now. No, before I get my breakfast. Right, well, I just need to snap, crackle and pop to the shop. Right.
Your mum let me in on her way out.
I thought you'd be jamming with Subal.
Always got time for my boy, eh? And on that, what would you say to a wee bit father and son kickabout?
I'd say we're past that.
Speak for yourself. Come on. I'm trying to reach out here.
Aye. You're trying to get me to do something that I hate.
By trying to get you to give it one last chance. Down the basketball courts?
Football. In a basketball court, how does that work?
Jumpers for goals?
It's Baltic.
So wrap up. Wear the scarf.
I can't, it's in the washing machine.
Who washes a scarf? You could spare my feelings a wee bit. At least pretend to like the thing I love.
Come on, the highbows.
Highbees.
Right, come on then, I'll give you a game.
Come on.
Unbelievable! Stealing out the Wayne's advent calendar.
Wasn't me. Was him.
Imagine wee Marcus's face when he wakes up to discover there's no chocolate behind that window tomorrow morning.
You! What were you thinking?
I'll replace that.
Nah, you better had.
All right, Grinch. You want to tell me what's really eating you?
Ellie.
Not as much.
I don't think she's coping.
I told you that herself, has she?
How can she when we're not speaking?
Whose fault is that?
You know it's not that simple.
Come on. After everything she said to you, it should be.
She's still my wee sister.
Yeah? So if she really wasn't coping, you'd be the first person she'd come running to.
Maybe. And maybe she'd go to Roisin.
Roisin?
Oh, saw them outside the Oyster, thick as thieves.
Ah. Well, there you are then. If she's got Doric Dear Deirdre, she'll be coping. Like, she's making a new friend, you know? That's a positive development, if you ask me. You just need to give her some space, you know? Or she'll never be able to stand on her own 2 feet.
Oh, maybe you're right. Aunt.
Of course I'm right. You know it. I know it. He knows it.
Stop. What the hell is this?
You can read, can you? Lenny's PI won't be bought, so you have to do the digging. Find out what he's got on Lydia.
But you just made me blow everything up between him and Jessie. I mean, like, Lenny's going to talk to me.
You have to make him.
I can't.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're sounding like someone who's actually got a choice.
Please, Darren. I just need some time away from all this to be with Jessie. I mean, they've taken everything really badly.
Oh, I can think of an even bigger bombshell they take really badly. Collateral damage.
That's my child you're talking about.
And you'd do anything to keep them safe. I'm not an entirely unreasonable guy. Get yourself into Lenny's inner sanctum. Then I'll give you some time off.
If. Funny how such a tiny word makes a monumental difference, eh? If they can remove an egg, if it's matured, if it can be fertilised, if it can be implanted, if I can carry it full term. If I could do this any other way.
But you canna. You've no way of caning if it's gonna happen. But you're still gonna head with it, am I right?
Stupid, eh?
Nah, nae stupid. Brave.
That's the thing, though. Brave's not. It's never been me. Seriously, lifelong fear, eh? Do you know when I was wee, if I needed a pee in the middle of the night, I used to have to wake Caitlin up to come with me.
Well, I'd say that's pretty brave, walking up big lassie up.
I'm no brave, Roisin. Ask anybody.
Why can't you see it?
You've known me, what, 2 minutes?
But you've put yourself through, all by yourself, just for even the sniff of a chance of hearing a wee baba of your own. That talks stones. You still sure you want me to talk to you the day?
Yeah, why wouldn't I? Oh, don't tell me you're going to back out now.
No, I'm not. Of course I'm not. It's just... I mean, you and Caitlin, you've aye been there for each other. Am I really who you want the day?
Yes, really. Caitlin's made it clear she's not supporting me.
Then I will.
Still no Jessie.
Stayed at Karen's again.
Staying over there more than here.
They think that's what's best for them.
Well, what do you think's best for them?
I thought I could trust Karen not to shut her mouth off.
Come on. She was always going to drop that bombshell.
Don't put this on me. Sorry. I can't lose Jessie.
They're not going to. I'll put it right.
Well, how exactly? I can't even be in the same room as you.
I'll find a way.
Well, make sure you do. Because I can't be your messenger. You did this, so you fix it. On your own.
Check that the coast is clear first.
You're fine. It's just Carl and his crew. Joking.
Ha ha.
Gemmell. Oh, good play by Gemmell. And again. Goes past one. Goes past two. Past three. He shoots! He scores! 3-1! A brilliant individual goal by this hard little professional puts Scotland in dreamland. Ha ha ha!
Scotland, Holland, 78.
So you do know something about football? You're a Tartan Army man?
No, I mind it through train spot and I'm a Kelly MacDonald man.
No supporting a club's one thing, but your country. Please tell me you watched the Euros. Not even our 0-0 victory over England.
I haven't watched a Scotland game since we played Costa Rica, 1990. I was 10.
That was a sickener, right enough. Did it break your wee heart?
No, just my ma's jaw. After that, whenever the football was in the telly and Paddy get the tinnies out, we knew to make ourselves scarce.
Paddy?
My stepdad. Whenever his team took a pounding, we took a pounding. Used to go and stay at my granny's. Wouldn't he come home until he'd slept at half.
I don't know what to say. Right. That's Paddy.
What?
Imagine that is Paddy. Give it a right big boot. Think of it as therapy.
Never did anything like this with a sheen.
Don't knock it till you've tried it. Give it everything you've got. Go on.
Had better no be Lenny Murdoch.
Who's Lenny Murdoch?
Trust me, you don't want to know. What do we do now?
Run.
I gave Mackenzie's baby bath away.
Can we not just use the sink?
Like we're going to be more on top of the dishes with a newborn.
Hey, I better add a new baby bath to the basket then.
Alongside a new cot, a new changing unit and a new baby gym.
How come you didn't just keep some of Mackenzie's old stuff?
With no room. So how are we suddenly going to find that now?
I'll click. I'll collect. And we can work it all out when I get back, right?
It's no spying. It's looking out for her.
Mm-hmm.
Turns out I am a baller after all, eh?
Fancy a rematch?
Do you fancy asking the Godfather of Shield Inch for your ball back?
No. I think our father and son footballing days might be over. Spectating, on the other hand, you might not enjoy what's happening on the pitch, but in the stands, pie, Bovril, 90 minutes of just you and me shooting the breeze. Do you fancy coming to the match with me tonight?
I'd love to.
You should have left it at the bottom of the clothes till Angus get back to help.
I managed it fine.
Oh.
It's bigger than I thought.
Or the flat's weirder than you thought.
What'll be all the packaging?
It better not be at that price.
It's not even going to be in this room anyway. And the baby will be with you first, and then...
What happens when the baby's not a baby anymore?
They'll share. With Kenzie. They'll be like roomies, he'll love that.
Aye, like you like sharing with Stevie.
Look, let's just get the crib built now, eh?
Okay, you're right. Baby steps.
Right, I just need to go and get something first before we get started.
The toolbox?
No, the ibuprofen.
Bathroom cabinet, third shelf down. On the house. Go on, it's the least I can do after everything you've done for my ma. And my sister.
What about your sister?
Seems you've been there for Ellie a lot lately. I'm grateful.
Just grateful?
Fine, I'm worried about her.
Have you told her that?
She doesn't want to know.
You'd be surprised.
Hey, what's she been saying?
The lassie came to me in confidence.
Is she a client?
She's a pal.
Well, since she's not a client, maybe you could tell me what's going on with her.
And break a promise to the sisterhood.
You've known Ellie for about, like, 2 minutes.
Funny. That's exactly what she said.
Well, there you are then.
Which marks it even sadder that she had to come to me instead of you.
I know she's got an appointment at the clinic today.
How'd you care not?
Can I reveal my source? Access to the online family calendar.
Ellie, at a clinic, what do you think that could possibly be about?
I take it she's still going for the IVF. What's that supposed to mean?
It means that I promised not to say anything, not that I wouldn't go. Or...
So I'm right? And she went in alone? You took her? And you've just abandoned her?
Says the inn that turfed her out this close to Christmas. I left her. Cos she's only allowed one person, and that person should be you.
What do you want?
I was looking for Alex.
All right. Can't be spirit away my son as well as my grandmother, eh?
Look, Jessie can make their own choices.
Chose to stay with us, remember?
Yeah, and that's what I wanted to talk to Alex about. But they've been staying with me a lot lately. They think they might want to make it more permanent.
So that was your plan all along?
Excuse me?
That's why you told Jess about Lydia.
Now, I was trying to protect them.
No, you were trying to get them to move back with you.
Look, I just want what's best for my child. I'm not the monster here.
Oh, and I am?
No, I never said that.
Yeah, well, that's what Jessie thinks.
Maybe not.
Don't try and play me.
They miss you.
Said that.
I mean, they didn't have to. Look, I just want Jessie to be happy, and as much as it pains me to admit it, they were happier at yours before all this blew up.
So what do you suggest I do about it?
Well, I mean, you need to talk to them.
No chance. Won't even come near me, never mind listening to what I've got to say.
Well, that's because they're stubborn.
Will I really go that for you?
It's a mystery. You know, I could try to get them to meet you.
You reckon Jessie will listen to you?
Well, there's a first time for everything. What would you say?
I'm sorry.
Sorry you killed Lydia, or sorry Jessie found out?
Both.
Okay, I'll bring them over to the flat.
When?
Give me till 5.
All right, thanks.
You know, I'm not doing this for you. I'm doing what's best for Jessie.
Nah, no way. She won't do it. Not all on her own.
She said she was just getting a think of it, like getting her tonsils out.
She had them out when she was 7. And before she went under, it wasn't my ma she wanted in to see her, it was me. I was just a wean too. They wouldn't let me into the theatre. So she was in one side of the door screaming for me. And I was on the other side, same, screaming for her, except louder.
I find that very hard to believe.
I would have given anything to have been able to hold her hand that day.
And what about today?
I'm still worried she's making a mistake.
Then she'll need you even more.
Well, she never gave me the chance.
You chucked her out.
The thing she said to me...
Oh, you'll get away. Maybe not today, but 10, 5 years down the line, you'll probably not even remember them. But if you didn't go today, what Ellie will I mind is that you weren't there for her when she needed you the most. And that, well, that's something you'll never get over. Belly, bum. Dies. She's had to inject herself that many times she's near run out of places to stick the needle.
Her daddy hates injections.
Nay, as much as she'd love a bear.
So, egg harvesting day. We've got here at last.
Only just.
You've done really well, Ellie. Can you just confirm it's been 36 hours since you took the trigger injection? That's great. I know the process can get a bit overwhelming.
It's a small price to pay.
Mood swings, bloating, abdominal and pelvic pains. She's had to go through it all.
Alone. Right, I get it.
It's invasive.
As you know, today is a short, simple procedure. Will they be putting her under?
She'll be sedated. So she'll be awake, but not very aware.
We'll pass a very fine needle into each ovary via the vagina to remove the eggs along with their fluid. We'll repeat this process until we gather all of them. Are you ready to proceed?
This is not happening. But it is. No.
She can't get through this alone.
Then hurry. Mark sure she doesn't have to.
Are you sure there's no family you want me to call?
No. There's no one.
Hit me. Right, which footballer holds the record for the highest number of league appearances for Hibernian FC?
Archie Duncan with 436 games.
Well, you're close. It's actually Arthur Duncan, and it's 446 games.
Right, give me another.
Oh, here's a nice easy one. What is the name of their home ground?
Tynecastle Park.
No, that's Hearts. They're arch rivals. Hibs play at Easter Road.
Easter Road, Easter Road, Easter Road.
Look, it's a football match you're going to. You're no sitting an exam.
I will just as well, seeing as I can't even get a nice, easy one right.
It's just a game.
I don't want my dad to be sorry that he invited me. I don't want to embarrass him.
Stevie, you made him happy the minute you said that you'd go. Taking your son to his first football match, that's a huge moment for any man.
And I don't want to ruin that.
And you're no going to ruin that.
It's 90 minutes. And me and him shooting the breeze. I need to know this stuff. What else is there to talk about?
You?
Me.
Well, that's what he wants to know about. It's you. He's asked to go. No Tam Cowan.
Do you know, I might not be able to talk the talk, but I can walk the walk. I'll wear the scarf that he got me.
Oh, here, that's a great idea.
Oh, no!
That doesn't look like a Hibs scarf.
Neither does that.
Oh.
What are you doing here? How did you... Roisin. She promised.
I forced it out of her.
Well, you need to leave, because the doctor should be back any minute.
Ellie, is this really what you want?
We can't all be like a dog pushing him out under the stairs, Caitlin. Why are you here?
Is this
a wee mishap?
It's a bloody big disaster. That's what it is. How do I fix it?
Buy another one.
This is a family heirloom.
Come on. A ring, a watch is a family heirloom, not a football scarf.
Sam's invited me to go and see the game. We're going to see the game tonight, and I've ruined it before we've even got there.
But son, you've not ruined anything. Okay, maybe that, but...
Sonny thinks that I should just straight out tell Sam.
Why, but there is that.
What do you think I should do?
Tell him you forgot it. Mum's a word. Mon Ibis!
How did we get to this, eh?
My mind's made up.
You should have asked me.
I don't need your permission.
To come with you. You should have asked me to come with you today.
After everything.
After everything. Like, all the other stuff, just put that on hold for now. I'm not here to tell you not to, Elliot. I'm here to support you. That is, if you want me to. What'd you say?
You're cutting it fine.
Blame Amber Cabs.
wouldn't have been so scared doing all this without you.
Oh, tonsils 2.0, eh?
Well, Mammy will be glad you get to be here for me this time.
She'd be here if she could.
Just so you know, I would have done this on my own.
I know. But if I let you do that, what kind of auntie would that make me, eh? Wow.
Aye, no bad, eh? Eh, we've kept more Kenzie stuff than I thought. I was just seeing what we could use.
Go to bed, Ted.
What? Oh, aye. So it is.
Yeah, right, you big softy. How long have you been sitting listening to that?
Most of the afternoon. It just feels like yesterday that we were bringing Mackenzie home for the hospital. Now he's like half the height of me.
More like 2/3.
Do you remember the first few weeks?
The mastitis? Like I could forget it.
Aye, but we got through it, didn't we?
We did?
Hey, I remember going out in the middle of the night to get you cabbage leaves.
Yeah. I don't know what I would have done without you.
And I'd have thought that we'll be bringing a new wee baby home soon as well.
I'll be bringing a new wee baby home soon.
Aye. That's what I meant.
Bob, you have been great about the baby. The best. But I've been thinking, I need to move out.
Anything you want to come in?
Could you blame me?
You want to leave us to it?
My mum stays.
It was the only way I could get this to happen. Now you need to listen to what your granddad has to say.
Why? There's nothing he can say that can justify what he did.
Jessie.
Keep away from me.
You're afraid of me? Come on, I could never harm you. You're my blood.
So is Dad.
That was different.
Your own son, your own blood, how is that different?
I was different.
And now you're Mr. Reformed.
Not completely. You've lived here long enough to know that. But I'm no murderer. I promised Lydia I would never kill anybody again. You'll be safe here.
Well, maybe I don't want to live here. Maybe I want to move back with Mum.
Jessie, I'd love that. I really would.
But?
But, I mean, your dad and I let you decide, and you chose to live here. I'm not going to pretend that that didn't hurt. But you're happier here. I mean, you finally got to be you here.
Maybe I don't like who that is.
Darling, was one slap. One mistake.
You don't want me back, do you?
Of course I do, Jessie. There's nothing more I'd want, but it's not about what I want. If you choose to move back with me permanently, it has to be for the right reasons, and not because you're running away.
Could you leave us?
It's down to you now.
But she can't. She said she'll find somewhere nearby that she'll not take Kenzie away from.
But why? She can just stay here.
She went on about how she went straight from living at home with her mum to getting married to Simon and moving in with him, then me. Said for the first time in her life she needs to find some space. Space, with two wings.
Well,
if it's space she wants, then space will give her.
What?
We need to think like 16 kids and counting.
But I've only got two to worry about. Less or something you've not helped me.
No, no, we need to think like Britain's biggest family. You know the ones off the telly? They bakers. I think they're at like 20 odd or something.
20 odd? Where do they all sleep?
Well, they've got like 4-story beds and all that.
Angus, you are a genius.
The procedure is over.
And? How'd it go?
We extracted 6 eggs.
6? Well, that's good, isn't it?
The average harvest is 10 to 20. We'll just need to wait and see if any of them are viable.
Can I go in and wait with her?
Of course.
Getting worried you weren't going to show.
As if. Tynecastle Park, here we come. I meant Easter Road.
You're fine.
I'm a failure. I've spent all afternoon swatting up nibs and I can't even get the name of the home ground right.
Well, you see, that's where you went wrong. You can't learn all about Hibs in an afternoon. Which is why I got you a season ticket.
So that must have cost a bomb.
Call it an early Christmas. You forget the scarf?
Aye. No.
So you actually did wash it?
With my ma's bra.
You wash your ma's bras.
No, she snuck it in. Are you nomad?
No. You are. Crazy. I thought you were just saying that because you didn't want to wear it.
But your dad gave you this, and you gave it to me, and I honestly thought that you'd be mad.
I'm no saint. I'm no paddy either. Come on. I think it's about time I bought my son his own scarf, eh?
Hey. How you doing?
I got 6.
You do know that 6 isn't really...
One. I only need one good one. That'll be like the first Christmas present I ever had that wasn't a hand-me-down of yours. Oh, don't worry. I'm not going to go off on one again. All that stuff I said about...
I'm trying to forget about it.
How about trying to forgive?
Let's just concentrate on getting through the day, okay?
I've got a good feeling about this.
Look, I get it. You've every right to hate me. But believe me, you can't hate me more than I hate myself.
You shot Lydia.
I was in the office, okay? It was dark, it was late. I had a few drinks, well, more than a few drinks. I didn't mean to.
No. You meant to shoot my dad.
Your dad betrayed me.
So you wanted him to die?
In that moment, yeah.
You'd have robbed me of my dad. Of my chance to ever get to know him.
Jessie, darling. In that moment, all I wanted to make him do was pay.
I'm afraid it's not the results we were hoping for. None of the eggs we harvested were mature.
But six?
Which I explained is not a high number.
Six?
Ellie, hen.
Oh, are you being funny? Because according to her, I can't produce a single decent bloody egg.
Oh. This is just the start of your IVF journey. We can begin another round of hormones, try another egg collection.
Can we just let her go over this one?
Of course. It's all still so raw. Why don't you bring your sister back in the new year and we can discuss next steps?
Right now, the only place I'm taking her is home.
I mean, we can't all sit bunched round the table at mealtimes.
No, I actually prefer teas on these in front of the telly.
What kind of example's that set, Kenzie?
Right, well, we'll get one of the ones that my gran had with the folding leaves.
Tell her about the sofa.
We get a smaller sofa.
Gives us more space.
Where are we all going to sit?
Just cut to the big idea.
All right. We have come up with an idea not only to make more room, but we have come up with an idea to make a room.
Introducing capsule living.
What's that when it's a home?
It's huge in Japan.
You mean tiny?
I see what you did there.
And we are bringing it to Montego Street.
I'll move in.
With me.
Which will free up a room for the weekend. When it's older.
So you're going to be sleeping with Angus?
Aye. No.
No, we turn my one room into two pods.
Pods?
Pods.
What's a pod?
Right. So you build one bed with one telly and one clothes rail.
And then you build another bed with one telly and one clothes rail on top of it.
So... basically, you're going to get a bunk bed.
Pretty much, aye. So, what do you think?
I love it.
You do?
Almost as much as I love you, pair of dafties. Ugh. I thought I needed my own space, but you've made me see that without you two, it'd just be empty space.
So does that mean you'll stay?
Like you, Mackenzie, and the baby?
Yeah.
Yes!
Yes!
Hold on. I'll be on the top though, right?
No. That's me.
No, but your wee legs will never get up all the rungs of the ladder.
But your bladder's the size of a pea. I'm not sleeping under that. You'll pee in my pod. Obviously, we've still got some minor issues to resolve.
Obviously.
You know, every day I see Lydia's face. Every day I relive what happened. I see him so. There's nothing. Nothing I wouldn't do to go back and undo what I did.
Dad and Uncle Rory and Auntie Amber must have loved her.
Very much.
And they've forgiven you.
They found a way to live with it.
Then I should too. On one condition.
Name it.
That you go to the police. Confess.
You're late.
You're welcome. Well, I got you what you wanted.
I'm not the one who should be indebted here.
I got Lenny and Jessie talking again. I brokered the peace. Lenny Murdoch thinks that he owes me.
That's it. I wanted intel.
He made a promise to his dearly departed Lydia that he'd never kill again.
The legendary Lenny Murdoch.
No longer quite so legendary. Now, have I earned myself a break?
Sure. I'm a man of my word. Have Christmas Day off. Actually, second thoughts. The eggnog flowing, tongues loosening. Scrap that. Get your feet under the Murdoch Christmas table.
What?
Get me everything he has on Lydia.
She'd probably have done this that night. But then, I wouldn't have got to meet you, eh? Save them cutting it after in the neck. I want you to make sure that I get to your Uncle Rory, okay? And you look out for your Aunt Amber. She's not as tough as you'd like to make out. Hey, come on. This is all on me. You tell your dad the numbers 15-02-04. I changed the combination last week. I put in
my date of birth.
Aye.
We're closed.
Closed. I had. Did you seriously think I didn't recognize you the other day? As if I'd ever forget Scarlett O'Hara. You've done well for yourself.
Aye, I have. Smash up. So what do you want?
I thought you said you were closed.
I mean... Why are you here?
I think you know why. That's not your concern. What's mine is, that boy is my grandson.
Don't! I mean, don't do this, don't go.
Tell my face up to what I did. Who I am.
Who you were, remember? Every day. You said to yourself, every day you have to live with what you did. That's punishment enough.
No punishment's enough.
Grandad! Well, you can't. It's nearly Christmas.
Looks like I'll do anything to get out eating your nut roast, eh? good a time as any.
I don't want this.
I'll get through it.
But I won't! You go down for murder, you'll spend the last of your days in there. Don't make me lose my only grandparent. The promise that you made to Lydia, would you make it again?
I haven't broken it, sweetheart.
Would you make it again to me?
I swear to you, I'll never kill again.
You can get it.
Father Mulvaney.
Does he know?
The thing is, that night, I did confess. Just he was in the chapel.
Well, what's he want?
Just to talk.
Then you should go. Repent.
No. I'll be staying here with you.
I'll be all right.
Are you sure?
I'll get there.
My Stevie is nothing to you.
Oh, if only that was so. But I can do the maths. My Andrew is his father. This is the child I told you to get rid of.
Proud of yourself for that, are you?
I had my reputation, my son to protect.
Have I ever come to you and asked you for anything?
No, doesn't mean you won't.
I've got my reputation and my son to protect. My Stevie's the happiest he's been in a long time. And that is worth more to me than any share of your estate.
So, we're agreed then. This says, father unknown. Let's make sure it stays that way. Disobey me a second time, and I will destroy you.
Hey. We should get a two-storey sofa.
Is there such a thing?
Well, if there's no, there should be.
Will you stop? I'm not going anywhere.
Guess I better go and get that.
Two-storey sofa. Lou? I'm afraid I've got some news for you. Simon's being released.
How come the scumbag's getting let out the now?
Good behaviour.
Well, that must have taken some doing to cancel out the whole escaping and holding us hostage situation.
He's very good at manipulating people.
He's only been let out on licence. He'll go straight back inside if he breaks any of his conditions.
Conditions? What kind of conditions?
Well, the main one is he has to reside at the permanent address that's been approved by a supervising officer. It's not in Shieldinch.
So what's the point in telling Kim then? Freaking her out in her condition?
You need to know, just in case he turns up here.
Which he won't.
Where else is he going to go? I've been dreading this day since the moment he was sentenced. It's not a question of if he turns up here, it's when. He's coming for me.
Mick. Come on, it's Christmas. Almost.
Save it for Santa.
Here was me thinking you were all about the baby Jesus. I just had to talk myself out of going to jail, well.
You were arrested?
Worse. Granwyn wanted me to hand myself in.
Or to be young, passionate, principled.
We were once.
We were never principled. I thought you said young Jessie was incorruptible.
Pretty much.
So how come they never marched you straight down the station?
Ah, pretended I was going to hand myself in. Jessie ended up talking me out of it.
You played them?
Not my finest hour.
Dangerous game. You could have just said, Lydia might still be alive.
Not until I'm sure. Jessie'd been hard enough. What have we got?
You were right. The name Mary Stewart, red herring.
You couldn't trust Grant.
But that's not all you were right about. The other name, Charlotte Murphy, came up trumps. Got a copy of her passport.
I was right. What is a life?
You need to get out and about again.
He's just worried about you.
We could try being a bit more worried about my ex. Can't the police stop him? For all I know, he could be round that corner right now.
How many boxes did you order?
9.
I said 4.
Would you like to go for a coffee?
I can't. I have to sell all these today.
I'm sorry, it's not good news. It may be the case that Ellie has no more viable eggs left. All it takes is one viable egg. I'm not giving up on this, Caitlin. I'm prepared to do whatever it takes.